Alright guys, welcome back. So today what I want to do is give you guys sort of my longevity review or my full opinions on the belts that you see laying here on the counter. And these are my Core Essentials belts, and I got these a little over a year ago, and Core Essentials was nice enough to send these to the channel, so I really do appreciate that. But I've been using these things every single day for the past year, and I just wanted to let you guys know how the belts are holding up, show you guys some wear and tear on them, how I've been using them, and things like that. Now, you're gonna see these two different belts, and there's gonna be different wear on both of these belts because I did use them sort of a little bit differently, and one had a little bit harder use and one was more of a casual use, and you'll kind of see the differences in the wear on the two different belts. But I gotta say, I've had a great experience overall with these belts, and probably my favorite features, and I know that you guys are probably aware of the Core Essentials belts. I know there's a lot of you guys out there that run them. There's a lot of videos here on YouTube about them. They're all over social media, so I know they're probably not anything new to some of you guys, but if you're not familiar with them, really what struck my interest the most with these and what probably is my favorite feature of these belts is the way that they attach, and that is using their TrackLine system. And I'll kind of show you here on this belt right here on the back. That is their TrackLine system, and that is how, you know, you don't have any holes, no holes to attach it to. You use this TrackLine, and what's great about it is it has, I think, 40 plus different adjustment points. And they're in quarter inch increments. So if you put the belt in and you hit them, you're gonna hear that clicking. That is how you adjust the belt. And once you have it where you want it, it's rock solid, not going anywhere. But what I like about this, and probably what's most frustrating about trying to order a belt or get any type of belt, is you normally have holes in the belt that are spaced about an inch apart, and it never fails that the one is too tight, the one is too loose, and you can never get a great fit. And then when you're online trying to order a belt, especially a gun belt, you know, you got to make sure you get the exact right size, and every company measures differently and tells you how to order it differently, and it can get confusing, and you end up ordering the wrong one. You got to send it back. It's a hassle, but that's not the case with these belts. You buy them and they're more or less a one size fits all. It goes from like size 28 up to size like high 50s or something like that, and you just cut the belt and to your size, and then put the buckle on, and you're good to go. So you don't have to worry about it when you're ordering it. You just cut it to how you need it, put it together, no issues at all. So I really do like that, and like I said, it's probably my favorite feature of the belt, because you know, there might be some days that you carry a bigger gun, some days you might carry a smaller gun. So if you say you're carrying the Glock 43, you might have this thing ratcheted a little bit tighter, but say you want to change things up and carry a P01 or a Glock 19 or something a little bit bigger, you can just take and adjust it out a couple and you're good to go. You don't have to worry about the belt being too big or too small or too tight or whatever. You can make them small quarter inch adjustments and really tailor it to whatever you're carrying, whether it's inside the waistband, outside the waistband, whatever. I absolutely love it. So some wear and tear on the belts. We'll take a closer look at them. We'll start off with the black belt here. And what I've used this one mostly for is, you know, say after work when we're going somewhere, I'm going to carry my gun, and I usually wear this belt here. So it doesn't have quite as much wear as this one, and we'll take a look at that here in a second. But this still has got, you know, a lot of use, you know, carrying guns in and out of vehicles and, you know, doing stuff around the house, things like that. So it does have, you can see, it's actually a little bit dirty. Should have cleaned it up first. You can see kind of some dirt there, but it does have a few small little nicks here and there in the leather, just from, like I said, you know, casual use, bumping into things, getting in and out of vehicles, catching on stuff. You do see a little bit of wear there on the buckle, but overall, the belt's in what I would say is in excellent shape for using it pretty much every single day, just not a lot of hard use. So this belt has held up great. Now, this one here has had a lot more use to it. And to just give you guys a little bit of background, What I do for a living, I have a nail belt on a lot. I'm in crawl spaces, I'm in attics, I'm doing a lot of stuff where your belt's getting a lot of hard use on it. So you're gonna see a little bit more use on this one. And then that was along with carrying guns as well. So you're gonna see that you do have some scuffing here on the buckle, and that's mainly from, you know, the big belt that you wear when you wear a nail belt. So that was rubbing against it. So it does have a little bit of wear there. You can see right here on the top of the leather, some stuff have been hitting on it, crawling around in crawl spaces, stuff like that. So this has some pretty hard use to it. Not just carrying a gun. These are my everyday belts. You can see it does have some nicks here, but overall, the belt is still in excellent condition for a lot of hard use that I've put it through. And I'll show you guys the inside of it, just see if there's anything on the inside. You can kind of see on the track line right here, there is a little bit of, I don't know what you would call that. It's not quite straight. It has had a lot of pressure on it right here, a lot of movement right there. So it is not quite straight anymore, but it still works 100%. And I've never had any issues with it coming loose or not wanting to adjust or tighten or anything like that. It still works perfectly, even though it has had quite a bit of use to it. So these belts have really held up excellent for the amount of abuse that I've put these things through, carrying guns, working every single day, and all that. So in my opinion, they're great overall belts and they're excellent gun belts. So now what I wanna do is show you guys a different variety of guns that I've been carrying to give you an idea on what these belts can handle, being sort of a casual light duty EDC belt. And let me show you those guns so you get an idea on what you can carry and what'll work comfortably and stuff like that with these particular belts. Okay, so laid out here on the table is a variety of different handguns that I carry on a regular basis, and as you can see, they range from small, like the little Glock 43 here, up to the bigger P07 with the 17 round mags and the threaded barrel, all the way over to the Smith & Wesson 686 over there in the top corner. That has a little more weight to it, and everything in between. We got a Glock 19, we got the 2.0 compact, we got my P01, and so I carry a wide variety of sizes and weights and things like that, and a lot of inside the waistband, but some outside the waistband, and for the most part, these belts have worked out great for carrying everything that you see here on the table. Now, probably what gets carried most is my little Glock 43 here, and my Harry's holster Insider. It's just small, lightweight, easy to carry, and works best for most situations that I find myself in, going out for the evening or whatever, quick run to the gas station, whatever. This is just easy to throw on. It's small, it's lightweight, it's compact, and it works out great. But I do carry other guns from time to time, like we got my CZ-P01 here, and this is in my Klinger holster, inside the waistband holster. This works out fantastic. The belts handle this size gun, this weight of gun perfectly. The PO or the 2.0 compact, again, in a Harry's holster Insider. This works out fantastic. The belt holds this no problem. The Glock 19 is in the Bravo Concealment Torsion holster. Again, fantastic, works perfectly. And this one here, my P07, is still set up in the Harry's holster in the appendix carry position. And again, the belts hold this no problem. Now, where I've started to carry outside the waistband a little bit more, especially now in the winter months. And I've noticed that although the belts do work great for outside the waistband, I might be a little better suited to try out their tactical gun belts, as they call them, the more heavy duty. They say that they're about twice as rigid and strong as the belts that I've got, and they'd probably work out a little bit better than the belts that I have now. So I might give them a try. But with that being said, I've carried these different guns outside the waistband and it works great. They just do kind of tug on them a little bit. So a more rigid belt, like their tactical series of belts, might work a little bit better. And just to give you an example on the outside the waistband stuff, this is my 3-inch 686 Plus that I've been carrying outside the waistband in this DeSantis leather holster. And I did pick up a DeSantis holster for my Glock 43. I've been carrying it, and really no issues outside the waistband, either, you know, inside or outside with the Glock 43. It's just small and light and stuff like that. But I did pick up a Winthrop holster for my P01, and I've been carrying it outside the waistband a little bit. And again, being the, you know, the all metal gun, the you know, the compact size all metal, it is a little bit a little bit heavier than say the Glock 43 or the Glock 19 or whatever. So it did tug a little bit on the belt, still carried okay, but I think I'd be better off with one of their tactical series belts. And then again, I've got a Bravo concealment outside the waistband holster for my Glock 19 with the pancake loops on it, and it works out great. But again, I think the tactical belts, if you're going to carry something heavier, like the P01 or even the 686 Plus, which has a decent amount of weight to it, you might be better off looking at their tactical series line of belts to better suit the for the outside the waistband carry. But this is kind of a variety of guns that I carry and have had great luck with both the guns, the holsters, and the belts. It's just an all-around good system with these guns here. And I know a lot of people like to see and hear how you use the belts, what you use the belts with, so I wanted to just give you guys sort of a look at what I carry on a daily basis and how it's worked out with these particular belts. Okay, so as you can probably tell by the way I've been talking about these belts in this video, I absolutely love them. Over the past year or so that I've had these belts, they have done everything that I've needed them to do. You know, first and foremost, they allow me to carry my guns, and they keep them solid and from moving around. And you know, that was the main purpose of these, and they have executed that perfectly. They're actually a really good looking belt. So even if you're not carrying a gun and you got to dress up a little bit, you know, they're a good looking belt. And you know, I've put them through a lot of use, like I told you guys, both carrying guns and while I'm at work. I do have a manual labor job. I find myself in odd situations where the belt's getting hit and tugged on and rubbed up against stuff. And you know, looking at this belt, you can see that it has a lot of abuse to it, but no real damage, just a little bit of wear here and there. So they've held up great, and I've been absolutely satisfied with them. And of course, that TrackLine system is just absolutely fantastic. So if you are looking for a good casual everyday carry belt, I cannot recommend the Core Essentials belt highly enough. Now, I have not tried out their heavier duty tactical belts, which I do plan on. I'm gonna try to get one and see how those work out, see if they do a little bit better on the outside the waistband carry with the heavier guns. And of course, we'll do another video and I'll let you guys know how those work out. But for what 99% of us need, if we're gonna carry a gun inside the waistband, just an everyday belt, these Core Essential gun belts are hard to beat. But anyhow, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope some of you guys found this helpful. If you're looking for a new EDC belt, definitely take a look at Core Essentials. I'll pop their website up right here on the screen so you guys can go over there, check them out, see all the different options and colors and different belt loops or different belt buckles and all the different stuff that they offer. They really do have a lot of stuff, so go check them out and see if this belt is something that might suit you. But down in the comment section, let me know if you guys run one of these belts or what belt that you guys like to run and stuff like that. I would love to hear what you guys use and all that. But anyhow, guys, I appreciate all of you guys watching, and we'll catch you in the next one.